ask you something while you're here? What kind of music do you like?
I love everything except for country! Whoa.
All right, what is going on, guys? Welcome to the commentary. Here I'm going to be going over how I've been working around my pec injury the past couple weeks. Generally, you're going to want to take 2 to 4 weeks off when you experience a minor strain like this. And this is just a fairly minor one. You know, it could be longer depending on the severity of the strain. I generally stuck between 8 to 12 or 12 to 20 reps throughout this time. Just kind of keeping things generally on the lighter to moderate end, because even on some other stuff like a row, for example, or a lat pull down, you still might feel your pec coming into play a little bit. Again, it just depends on how severe yours is. But to start this workout, we went with some cable internal and external rotations, just 2 to 3 sets of anywhere from 15 to 30 reps. Something you can do here too, if lats are something you really want to focus and you're lacking in that upper portion of the lat right underneath the shoulder, that's the teres major. If that's something that's lacking, you can perform these internal rotations to a greater level of fatigue, do three to four sets even, and pre-exhaust that muscle group before going into some lat pull downs and stuff like that to potentially help bring that muscle group up. So next we go into a low machine row. Upper traps are a weaker muscle group for me, so that's something I've been focusing on. So I like to prioritize some kind of movement that really focuses the middle to upper traps. So for this whole workout, I'm just doing pyramid sets of 12, 10, 8. Everything is 3 sets since we're doing most of the upper body. Again, just avoiding anything that irritates the chest. So of course, any form of press, even a front raise was really agitating me. And even some curls and even like a lot of stuff was messing with me. So just kind of feel it out. Depends on your specific injury, but yeah, so we start light. Again, always hit at least 2 to 3 warm-up sets, even when you're just generally working with lighter weight. Definitely recommend some warm-up sets to build that mind-muscle connection and just get everything moving. So here, I just really focus on my hands as being hooks, pulling through those elbows, and just squeezing those shoulder blades up and back. Pull with power, but get that squeeze at the top. When it comes to progression on these, you know, so if in these pyramids, I'm looking at it as first set, I want to do 12 reps, 10 reps, 8 reps on the third set. I'm really thinking of it as like 12 to 14, 10 to 12, 8 to 10, that type of thing. So obviously I'm trying to push to failure within that rep range. And then my goal is to increase the weight by roughly, you know, anywhere from 10 to 20 pounds, just depending on how you're feeling. So next we move on to a mid cable row. You're going to notice that I'm really focusing the middle back in this workout. You know, I'm hitting upper body twice a week. So what I was doing was actually having one session that was a little more middle back focus, focusing on thickness, and then the other day would be more lat focus or width focused. So on these mid cable rows, the very first thing I do is sit all the way back, pull my shoulders back, and then I initiate the movement. You know, this gets you set up, your core should be tight, you're already getting some pre-activation going by pulling those shoulders back, you know, you're squeezing those shoulder blades together a little bit. And getting that locked up, and then you control it through the elbows. Don't let those shoulders come all the way forward. Keep those middle traps slightly contracted, tight core, chin is tucked, and squeeze those shoulder blades back on every rep. And you can allow yourself to come forward just a little bit. If you're really trying to focus lats, this is something where you could come way more forward, get a deeper stretch in the lats. But I was really just trying to focus those middle traps right here. Just nice and controlled, getting a good solid 1 to 2 second squeeze every rep here. You'll notice too, I did decide to use the handles. It just gives you a little bit more free range of motion. You can rotate your palms down and in, which just feels a little bit more natural. But yeah, that's totally up to you. If you prefer the bar, you can go that route as well. So then we move on to the reverse grip straight arm lat extension. I just recently started using this reverse grip because I felt like when I was using overhand, I was just feeling my chest come into play a little bit. By going reverse grip, it just completely took that out. And it actually has a really great contraction. You do, the lats of course come into play, but you actually get some more of the middle trap activation as well, which I really liked. Just all around felt really good. So definitely try this out. If the overhand lat extension doesn't bother your chest at all, you know, you can still use that and get some more lat activation. But I was just feeling really good with this movement. And again, focusing more of the middle back overall, it felt like. And when I'm doing these, I'm just thinking of swooping, making like a big semicircular motion, like swooping down through my elbows, just down and back all the way into my hips. You know, the elbows are bending a little bit, and that allows you to extend through the elbow and squeeze your shoulders down and back. And on these, and you'll just kind of notice across all the exercises in general, I like to start out slow and controlled, and then as I fatigue, I'll speed it up a little bit. This is a technique you can use to push past fatigue a little bit. So then we're getting into our isolation movements for the extremities. On these, I'm doing 4 sets each, since we're only hitting 1 exercise for each of these muscle groups. Again, you can adjust this based on your fitness level or just how you're feeling. I stuck to 3 to 4 sets on each of the back exercises, and then just 4 sets on all of these upcoming exercises. Everything is the same in terms of the progression. It's a pyramid. You know, you're just sticking to 8 to 15 reps, start lighter, increase weight each set. So here I decided to superset side raises and shrugs. I've always really liked this combo. You make sure to focus the lateral delts first because the traps do tend to come into play. And then you're finishing off with the traps, especially, again, you know, they're a weaker muscle group on me. I find that I get really good activation on them right after hitting the lateral delts. You'll notice on these side raises, your elbows are a little bit bent, so the hands are coming a little bit in front of the shoulder, but the elbows are perfectly in line with that lateral delt. I do rotate in a little bit, but I don't do that huge rotating motion where you completely flip your pinky upwards. I just keep it level for the most part. Just wherever, you got to feel it out yourself. You know, wherever feels best to you, wherever you get the most mind muscle connection to those lateral delts is what you got to stick with. And then on these shrugs, I always incorporate a little bit of some biceps just because I feel like it allows me to get a much better squeeze up at the top. I'm almost thinking of it as, you know, a little bit of a row. I even like to lean forward just a little bit to emphasize that up and back motion with the shoulders. So then we move on to cable reverse flies. This has definitely been one of my favorite movements for the rear delts lately. You just get such good tension across the full range of motion since it's on a cable. So here I'm focusing on keeping those shoulders locked down and back. You know, I'm not letting those shoulders go forward. I'm letting my elbows come across, and then extending back, get that good squeeze across your rear delts, but really across, you can see my entire back working here. You really get a little bit of everything, but holding that squeeze really helps get those rear delts in there. You'll also notice my elbow is coming down and back perfectly in line with my rear delt, just below being parallel to my shoulder where, you know, you might start to feel a little bit of that grinding. Again, you got to feel it out to see what feels best to you. All right, so then we move on to some reverse grip tricep pushdowns. I just felt like whenever I was doing any sort of overhand movement, I was getting some more chest activation. So being able to place my back up against a pad, use that underhand grip and just keep the chest completely out of it. I even let my elbows flare outwards just a tad, like to where I wasn't trying to squeeze my elbows against my torso, which again kind of starts to bring the chest in there. I would let my elbows just kind of hang out to the side a little bit, and then, you know, just focus on extending through the hands, get that good contraction. And then we finished with a close grip cable curl. This is one of my favorite movements right now for the biceps, especially with the minor pec strain. You can just keep your elbows locked in that position, not really have to use any effort to maintain elbows against your sides or anything. They're just locked there, and you just focus on curling through the biceps, simple as that. Again, getting that really good squeeze. I'm focusing on the squeeze on all these, and then just kind of burning them out in the end. All right, so next we're gonna be moving on to the recovery portion, where I work with Dr. Joe. I've been seeing him for a couple months now. He goes over some Graston with me and just talks a little bit more about the injury. All right, guys, so I'm here with Dr. Joe.
What's up, guys?
He's a chiropractor, and would you call yourself like a
soft tissue specialist.
Okay, soft tissue specialist, there you go. Like I was saying earlier, I've been dealing with a minor pec strain, and then a little bit of golfer's elbow. So for one, can you explain a little bit about what those two things are and then what you're gonna do to recover, and then we'll show you a little bit of like what he actually does.
Absolutely, yeah. So Justin just has a little bit of a pec major minor strain, right? Muscle strain, ligament sprain. And his golfer's elbow has to do with the medial portion of the elbow. Could be ligament, could be muscle, but the general term for any sort of strain to that area is golfer's elbow. So we're gonna use some Graston technique, which some of you might be familiar with, which are where I use a tool like this to get in there and break apart the scar tissue that the body is naturally trying to form to combat the injury, which in the grand scheme of things only makes things worse. So by cleaning up that scar tissue, cleaning up all the areas where the sprain strains are, it'll heal the injuries. I'm just gonna get a little bit of oil on the chest here. Just helps with the friction with the tools. Now, and as I'm doing this technique too, there's things that you look for and things that you feel for. With the normal pec muscle, you shouldn't feel any sort of tight bands or taut spots, anything like that. With Justin, you can feel it right away when you come across his pec muscle. It's rough. And you can see how his skin's turning red, and that is a histamine response. So that is telling us that, okay, something's going on in here and we need to focus a little bit more onto it.
And he's really not applying that much pressure, guys. Like, it doesn't feel hard.
And it shouldn't be that painful. Okay, and then what you'll start to see is an actual adhesion that's starting to show up right here. And that's a spot where there actually is scar tissue that we're actively breaking apart. You know, it kind of looks like a hickey.
Just so you guys can kind of see what's going on there. See how it's getting, it's already that red with hardly any pressure. So that tells you something's going on there.
It's always important when doing this technique, you can see I'm brushing towards the start of the lymphatic system, which is this region right into here. Because if we flush it down this way, then all this fluid and inflammation will just stagnate right here. So we want to push it all up this way, which encourages the blood flow to that direction.
All right, guys, so this is something I've been doing, past couple, three, four months now?
We've been working.
Yeah. So when I first came in, or when I first mentioned the golfer's elbow, it was really bad. Like, I would say 100% being, you know, just fully functional, feeling good. I was at like 20%. Like, my form were just so locked up. Like, everything hurt, whether it was back movements, push movements, curling movements, whatever. Everything hurt. And now I'd say I'm up to a solid like 80, 85%. So it's helped a ton. I really appreciate you, Joe. I just highly recommend that you guys who are, you know, lifting regularly, you get in and do this stuff to prevent it long term. Like, doing this, like, I never plan on stopping this. Like, it'll always be at least once a month thing, just to ensure my health and longevity. So especially if you're an athlete, like, you know, regularly lifting 5-6 days a week, high intensity, you know, when you say that's incredibly important. Yeah,
you have to.
It's a must. And like, from a bodybuilding standpoint, I really feel like it's helped improve my symmetry. You know,
100%.
Equal length of the muscle fibers across both ends. Like, this is definitely the most symmetrical my physique's ever been, where I felt like my left side used to really lack because I was like a little bit lopsided in some areas, and this has just helped tremendously. So I just highly recommend it. So yeah, thank you, Joe. Appreciate you, man.
Very well.
So that does it for the upper body workout. Everything I hit was to avoid any sort of like pulling or pain in my chest or my elbows. So everything I did felt really good to me. There might be a few variations you need to try to have it feel the best for you while you're recovering, but definitely try some of those movements if you're dealing with some of the same issues and trying to recover. while, you know, minimizing muscle loss and just trying to maintain the best you can. Also, you know, there's a quick little posing session for you. You can tell I'm a little bit rusty. I haven't been practicing too much. But overall, like physique-wise, I feel solid. And then, yeah, guys, that soft tissue therapy has been the biggest change I've made this year. And although I'm dealing with like a few overuse injuries, I really feel the best I ever have. And like symmetrically, my physique is the best. Like I've never been able to look this good from the left side as well as the right. So I'm really happy about that. And I really attribute a lot of that to doing this therapy on a regular basis. So yeah, time to go home, get that post-workout meal in.